Hi! In this training video, I'm going to show you how to do some very quick keyboard shortcuts on your Webcaster X2. They're really fun to play with, and so basically you can use any USB keyboard if it's the type that has the little receiver. Those wireless ones work too with Webcaster, not a problem. And Webcaster has three USB ports, so you can connect your USB keyboard to any one of those ports. And I know I'm going to contradict myself in a moment, but that's okay. So just plug it in, and the main ones that you can do with a keyboard when you're using your Webcaster is the escape key. And you'll notice right here that hitting the escape key turns the menu item on and off. The other really important one that you can do with your keyboard is the space bar. And you're going to start and stop streaming hitting your space bar. Now, I'm not paired, so that's why this pairing code has appeared, and that's okay if it's encouraging me to pair. But if I was paired, then hitting the space bar would start streaming and stop streaming, and you could tell also by the green button on the green LED would be flashing or non-flashing when I'm streaming or not. So just going to right click anywhere here and get rid of that pairing code. What you can do now also with your keyboard is use it if you're also using the USB camera feature. Now that's a beta feature, but there's still a lot of fun that you can have with it using your keyboard. And this is where I'm going to contradict myself. There are three USB ports on your Webcaster, but if you're going to use the webcam, then you need to use the webcam and plug it into the USB port on the same side of Webcaster as the HDMI in. So that way you're going to have to put your keyboard and your mouse into a different port, the ones of the USB that are on the back, and then plug in your USB camera here. So let's do it. And just plug that in. Okay, now once you've plugged in your USB camera, the first thing you're going to have to do is restart Webcaster. It requires a restart when you plug in a new device like the webcam. So I'm just going to let that come up and do its little restart and go through a power cycle here. Okay, so we're back up. I'm going to right click anywhere to get rid of that pairing code, and under preferences, I'm just going to click under preferences, and very quickly I'm going to change views. Okay, so you can see now that we have the preferences up. And you're going to want to check right here under Enable USB Camera Beta. And so basically now your USB camera is enabled. Now once you've selected the USB camera, you could also right here also choose to use the audio from the beta camera if you wanted to, but in this case we're not going to. And what you'll also notice is that down below, we'll just scroll down a little bit. Okay, they haven't shown up yet, but there are some other options that will appear. Okay, let's just right click to go out and then click on preferences again. Let's go down. Yes, and here you can see now we have the multi-source enabled options. They're all listed down here. Now, everything that's listed here you can pretty well do with your keyboard, and I'm going to show you how to do that. There's only one item that can't be done using the keyboard, and that's the transition here, the speed. Now it's usually on the off position, but I like the slow. It gives a nice smooth transition, but you can have the transitions very fast or medium. I'm going to put it back on to slow though. Okay. So now that you have the USB camera enabled, let's just see what we can do with our keyboard. The first thing I probably should mention is that the tab is going to switch between your cameras. So there's my webcam. Hi. And there's the PTZ camera that I happen to have connected to the HDMI port. The other thing you're going to want to know is that Shift M is going to bring up a different layout. It's actually going to switch between layouts. Now the reason it's switching between these two layouts is that I have the side-by-side layout selected. So let's talk about the different layouts. You can have all from one number one to number eight on your keyboard to give you different layouts. So this would be number one, this would be number two, three, four, five. Six is side by side, seven is three quarters left, and eight is three quarters right. Now, if I shift M again, let me just show you. We're going from our main camera shot to the multi-camera shot that I've selected. So shift M basically turns multi-camera on and off is what's happening. Now, with that turned off, if I hit tab, I'm still switching between the two cameras because I have them connected. I'm just not using the multi-camera mode. So shift M to turn the multi-camera mode back on. So once, let's say I like this layout, this is a nice one, this is the picture-in-picture, I can actually readjust the position of the picture-in-picture just by using the home key. And it's going to shift it down a bit, it adds more padding. If I hit the end key, it removes some of that padding, as you can see here. I'll just add that back in. And if I hit the plus key, it's going to make it bigger, and the minus key makes it smaller. There we go. Ah, that's a little too small. There. And I can also change the transparency just by hitting the page down and page up key. So if I go page down, you see the transparency gets more and more transparent, and page up to get back to the full shot. And another fun one, and this is, you can actually rotate your different views. Now I'm just going to go to the side-by-side view. That's number six on your keyboard. Gives a nice side-by-side view. And if I just want to, I could use the square bracket, and it's going to shift this guy. It's going to rotate him all the way around. There we go. Lots of fun. And the closing bracket will shift and rotate, or just rotate the other source. Now, if I hit the tab in this view, you notice that it's switching my sources. So it's just basically switching which one is the primary source and which one's the secondary source. So I've switched from primary and secondary, and now you see the I can rotate the keys affecting the source, not like it's a primary source that's being switched. And using the up and down arrow keys will also switch the layouts as well. As you notice here, I'm using the right arrow key and I'm shifting to the other layouts. If I use the up arrow key, I'm going to shift into the picture in picture. Now my down arrow keys and my left and right arrow keys are going to move the picture in picture around. So there's a lot that you can play with here once you have your keyboard going, and you can play around, you can set up different views and switch between them, and there you go. Like, subscribe, have fun, and we'll see you with the next training video.